The National Review launched in 1955, and it was immediately a literary and political success. Buckley's magazine, however, didn't endorse a candidate for president for nearly a decade. But in 1964, the movement found its man.
What was it about Goldwater that somehow brought together conservative elements politically?
I think Goldwater had an intuitive sense that there was American impatience at two levels. Number one, successive Soviet victories, and also simultaneously American impatience with the failure after 30 years to solve social problems, which were, if not as pronounced as during the Depression, at least there. So when Nixon was defeated, running in 1960, there was kind of a search for an alternative who would present a general alternative over against what was being offered, and then Goldwater ran.
The senator had a relationship with National Review. He knew Bill Buckley.
You must remember that Brent Bozell, who was Bill Buckley's brother-in-law and a roommate at Yale and an editor of National Review in the late 1950s, was simultaneously speechwriter for Barry Goldwater. And indeed was the principal author of Goldwater's book, The Conscience of a Conservative. So, yes, there was a tremendous overlap between what National Review was trying to do and what Goldwater was doing in the political sphere.
If you're asking the question, could Goldwater have been fielded if it hadn't been for the background work done by National Review, I would say no, probably he wouldn't have.
Though the National Review helped draft Goldwater, Buckley was kept out of the campaign by Goldwater's campaign manager.
He argued that, well, National Review has too conservative a perspective and too conservative a reputation. It wouldn't be good for the campaign.
Bill was a stand-up guy. He didn't start complaining. He just took it. He kept on carrying on the message through the National Review of the conservative movement.
Barry Goldwater, the senator, said later that was a mistake. He should not have let that happen. That Bill Buckley should have been part of the campaign, and he regretted that it wound up that way.
Then he had, of course, his disastrous loss. But that disastrous loss is now acknowledged by historians as by no means a loss of his ideas, but rather a temporary political loss. Several historians have mentioned that conservative support post-1964 ballooned.
So despite Goldwater's loss of the presidency, it energized the base and the regional conservatism.
Absolutely.
The next major conservative to run for office was Buckley himself.
Conservatives sort of felt that they needed to redeem themselves politically. And this mayor election comes along in New York City, and for whatever reason, Bill Buckley decides to be a third-party candidate.
What fun. All the speeches. Just think. And a book to follow.
Riding in on a white horse is not Loch Navarre or the Lone Ranger, but is Bill Buckley. Bill Buckley running for mayor, running in New York City, you know, the heart of the enemy camp, was not just an idea, but had real relevance politically.
Buckley's opponent was Republican Congressman John Lindsay.
Lindsay was viewed as, I think, the sort of heir apparent to Nelson Rockefeller and the one that would dominate the liberal Republican side. Buckley comes along and just challenges him at every sentence in the campaign. I
mean, if anyone doubted that Goldwater's victory over sort of the Rockefeller wing of the party was deserved or not, those doubts would have evaporated upon seeing Buckley dismantle the arguments of John Lindsay. The sheer intellectual incoherence and speechlessness that he was reduced to by Buckley's arguments, I think, was a profound confirmation of the fact that that the liberal control of the Republican Party was not only ending, but it was justifiably ending.
Buckley knew he never had a chance of winning. I mean, there's the famous line that he said, if some reporter asked him what he's going to do if he wins, he said, I'll demand a recount. You know?
The last conservative who had run citywide had gotten 1% of the vote. I got 13.5%.
And the fact that Buckley did as well as he did was a kind of leading indicator, I think, that the disorder in the cities and the chaos on the campuses, which was more in the future at that point, but still beginning, would have tremendous cultural effects, which would help the conservative movement become, a leading political force in the country.
Coming up, Buckley and Richard Nixon after the news break.